From the News Channel 5 Network, I'm Rory Johnston with your latest headlines. Two men wanted for attempted homicide after forcing their way into a Goodlettsville home. Happened around 11 last night on Brick Church Pike. Police say two men forced their way into the home and shot two people. One of them has been released from the hospital, the other in serious condition. Police say the suspect stole a four-door silver Toyota Tacoma pickup when they left. A sixth grader charged with bringing a gun to school. Police say the boy showed the gun to other kids at Pleasant Hill Elementary today. Fortunately, those students then told staff members the school resource officer got the gun. It was an unloaded, small caliber handgun. The student is being held in custody pending a hearing on Monday. All right, if you plan to be on the roads this weekend, TDOT officials say you got to be careful. With winter weather on the way, crews will be treating roads that usually have the most problems during winter weather snaps. They're laying down brine, but only in some areas, not everywhere, because there is also rain in the forecast before any snow and ice, and TDOT officials say that'll just wash away the brine. Bridges, of course, big trouble spots. Be careful. Snow plows are also geared up and ready if they are needed. We'll get the latest track of the storm. Here's Bree.
Yeah, it looks to be a three-tiered system as we head into the weekend. So the first round slides in overnight tonight. It will mainly be rain, but the leading edge of it will likely have a mixture of snow and sleet. Not expecting much from this first round, just some sloshy conditions as you head out on roadways. Well, warm to 40, it's hard to call it warm, but that's warm enough to make it all rain by Saturday afternoon. Round two comes Sunday morning, and this has prompted a Storm 5 alert because this has the best potential for that wintry mix, especially along and north of I-40, mainly during the morning hours, and that will likely lead to some slick roads. Now Monday, as the system exits, there's a chance to see a few brief snowflakes as the system scoots out, but we're not expecting widespread accumulations.